Mike, you have a lot of top pro fighters. Let's start with the glory fighters. I will go through it quickly because in the featherweight division you have Sergey Adamchuk. What does Adamchuk has to do different this time to get that belt?
He has to go back to their first fight. In their first fight, Adamchuk was putting a fight on him, and it worked. And everybody knew this, and, except for a couple of judges, but these things happen.
I wrote it down. I know he got dropped a few times. That's why I ask you, fits in the hands of the jury, what does he has to bring this time to?
Yeah, well, besides this, you know, also the punching power of against Abraham Fidalis, if you combine this with the aggressive fighting style, it's going to be okay.
So he has to bring more aggression?
Yes.
Well, good luck on this one. Glory lightweight division, you have Stoyan Koprivlensky on number 7.
Yes.
But you also have Masary Glunder in this division.
Yes.
Will Masi stay in the featherweight or will he combine it with the lightweight division?
No. In glory, you can only fight in one competition, except if you're a guy like Pereira, you can fight in both divisions.
Because Rosmala was, he wanted to do 3 and then he did 2 and then he wanted to take.
He wanted to do 3. Yeah, but for Rosmala, it's not in glory anymore.
No, I want to say that. So they finished with 2 divisions then?
No.
Not for every, you just said
it. If you're special, everyone. You can.
He also trained here,
who?
Jiraiya.
No, just 1 or 2 times. That's all, you know. But we also win with metal of Jiraiya, so. But it's not about us against Jiraiya. You know, Jiraiya is a good fighter, and he's a young fighter, he's a promising fighter. And so are the other ones, so they're all young. So they probably end up fighting each other for another 4 or 5 times each, I think.
True, and this age, yeah. Why was Chris Baia dropped from the glory rankings? Because he was high, he was on number 4 or 3.
Well, he was, actually he was number 2. I think. But Chris had a little bit of bad luck, so they just put him out. And this year, 2020, he's going to be back in.
Glory.
And then he needs to fight up again and get himself ranked again.
Okay, like that. Okay, well, I hope to see him.
No, because he fights a lot of high-profile fighters and nobody does this, you know. You normally, his first fight was Josh Jones, and he fight tournament in the first round against a Russian guy. After that, he was fighting Massaro. Then he fight a guy from next to Croatia. And then he fight Siricai. After Siricai,
Marat.
He fought Marat. He fought Bestati. And Josh Jonesy again, you know. So these are all top 5 fighters. And
that's why I was surprised that he's not there anymore.
So you know,
he will be back.
You cannot always be on the top of your game.
But if he comes back, or when he comes back, then you will have 3 fighters in the lightweight division.
Somebody.
Because I remember Massaro versus Chris Baia.
Yes.
So you're prepared for that, of course.
Of course.
Of course, yes. Glory welterweight, Myrtle Groenart.
Yes.
He's got an interim belt.
Also correct.
And he's waiting on his rematch with Cedric Doumbé for the title fight.
It's not his rematch, his last fight he won.
But he has to, the belt is with Cedric now, so Myrtle has to fight him again to get the real belt back.
I know. But the last fight, Myrtle won. And the fight before, Cedric won. So it's still 1-1.
It's like a collision 3 for the welterweight division.
Something like that.
Does he have to wait for Cedric, or will he have any fights in between that?
No, he's next in line for Cedric, so we're waiting. We are waiting for the time that Cedric is ready. Because it's not on us, otherwise we would have fought, when we were fighting Troy Jones, we were fighting him. And Cedric Doumbé was the one who pulled out.
I know, yes.
Not us.
But you're going to wait how long for Cedric?
As long as we have to.
Okay, glory middleweight, Yusri Belgaroui, back on top, eh? Number two, he's now ranked.
Yes.
Is he?
Well, first we need to fight in Utrecht, you know, and then also the same with him. Wait on his chance. He's fighting the German guy who fought Stiebe Stube. He fought Kevin van Heekeren before.
Okay.
One of Kevin van Heekeren.
Okay, and my next question is, after that, would he be ready to face Parreira part 3?
Yeah, why not?
He's ready?
Well, why not? We need to train for this, of course, you know, because Parreira is getting better every fight. And,
special, eh?
Yes, he's very strong and he's very, but, you know, every, he cannot throw the six all the time, you know, so he has to be stopped somewhere.
You're waiting on your chance.
Of course.
Yes. So we will have another collision three in the light, in the middleweight division, yes. Then? And then we go quickly to the Glory Light Heavyweight Division. You have Donegi Abena.
Yes.
Also lost from Alex Pereira.
Yes, correct.
What's next for him?
Well, he has to wait. You know, he has to be cleared because of his last fight. He has to be cleared, and then when the doctors give him the okay, because he broke his wrist.
Okay.
And when he's okay, you know, he can fight again. So okay. We will see him.
And Mike, heavyweight division Glory, of course you have Badahari on three, and you have, you just said it, Placibat Antonio, who recently won at Glory 72 on a split decision from Jason Wilnes. He's ranked number 5, so is any chance he will meet Badr on number 3?
No. Out of the question.
Why them not, but the other divisions you allow it to? Like the
no, only in tournaments. That's normal. I told this one before. Only in tournament people can meet when they are in the final. And if not, not. There are enough other fighters and characters in the division. You know, some divisions has like 25, 30 people. So we can fight the other ones.
Placibat, did you know that he's nominated for Glory Newcomer of the Year 2019? Of course,
I saw this. And he's entitled to, because he did it very well. He's coming from nowhere and he was there all of a sudden.
And did they already accept the winner or not?
No, not to me.
Not yet. No, I didn't hear it either. Then we move quickly to K1. You have Jordan Piqueur.
Yes.
5 times K1 Crush Champion.
And counting.
That's a big, big, big accomplishment.
No, yes, well, I think he defended 5 times. He won him the first time.
By
Wikipedia. Okay. And, well, if it was by us, you know, we had also the 76 K1 belt in our hands. But this guy, Yuta Kubo, he, every time when the fight is on, you know, he's injured, so that's the problem.
And because Piqueur, he fought at K1 many years ago as well.
Yes, we started out at K1 as, how do you say, as a late substitute.
And
then, we lost in the finals of Marat.
Yeah, I was just about to say. I didn't know that he fought Marat until I checked the Wikipedia.
Yeah.
Rumors about him going to Glory, true or not true?
Yes, it's true.
It's true?
It's true, but we don't know yet. He's good where he's at now. And I think he's gonna be a champion for another 3-4 years. So.
But Mike, yes. If he comes to Glory, then you will have 4 in the lightweight division.
Yes, I cannot help that, you know. And that's not my fault. You know, I just, I'm a trainer. And my job is to produce fighters, so this is what I do. I produce fighters. And at the end of the day, you know, if the fighters are attractive, and they fight the way the people want to see it, and then why not?
So we hope that there will be a tournament then with the four fighters. That would be unique.
Yes.
But when is he ready for the K1 GP Grand Prix belt, Jordan Piquer?
I don't know. First we need to fight, the next fight is going to be for the 67 kilo belt against Yuta Kubo, and if not, it's going to be the K1 Grand Prix, minus 70.
Minus 70, okay. Yes. But he's going for a title fight then?
No, just the Grand Prix, just for the tournament, and then after that we'll see what happens. You know, the thing is to claim as many belts as we as possible.
Belt collector. Melanie Geugers, K1 cross champion.
Yes.
K1 fighter as well,
hè? Used to be K1 champion. Cross champion.
Cross champion.
Yes.
She recently fought at K1.
Yes, and lost, unfortunately. But, you know, the fight was so close, it could go two ways. Mm-hmm. And I think the other girl is more suitable for Kana, the favorite. So
local, eh?
Simple.
Michael, what weight is Melanie?
Melanie, between 56 and 52.
56. Any chance she can join Glory Bantam weight division?
Yes, she can.
Will she?
Yes, she will. She wants. You know, sometimes we talked about it, but, you know, after three times bringing her up, you know, and I don't want to be that guy that every time they see me, they say, oh, there's that guy who wants to put Melanie in. No, they just need, she has to be in because Glory wants her in.
But I think she deserves to be in because they have only now five top girls there. So there's place, there's room in the division.
Yes, there is. Well, I don't know if they got five top girls, they got more girls.
Yeah, but their ranking goes five only. Like not a temp, not even a top 10 list, they have only five in the ranking.
Yeah, they have more.
No, they have more in the
lower.
But they only have a ranking list of five
people. Yes, it's understandable because some don't belong there, in my opinion. Yes, okay, but you know, you need to have people, otherwise you don't have a competition. Yes.
Because the bantam weight I checked is 55.3 kilograms, so Melanie can easily...
There's no problem.
Okay. Fabio Quassi, he has an 8-man tournament coming up at Osfaltis in Romania.
Yes.
35,000 euro prize money with the return of Lazar. Who do you see in the finals?
Depends who they got, how do you say? Depends who they got lined up in the tournament. Because so far it's not sure. He got this guy Ristea, he's the hometown favorite, so they're gonna give him the easy side of the bracket, I think. And Fabio and Lazar is gonna end up in the semifinals,
I think. So, yeah?
Now in the semifinals against each other, and then the winner of this is gonna go against Ristea in the finals.
That's your vision.
Yes, because I don't know who the other.
There's one Greek, the
five guys.
There's one
There's one Greek guy, yes.
And he was also in a tournament at the Fusion in Abu Dhabi.
So yes.
He had ring activity, unlike Lazar.
And then he did very good in this tournament. No, but that's true. You know, it's one Greek guy.
But I mean, he has more activity than Lazar, more ring activity.
Yes, okay, but that's it.
Yeah.
But Lazar, I think, is ranked better. He's more dangerous than the other guys.
Because I talked to the promoter, Alex Philip, and he asked me the same question. So I said that Quade will either face Ristea in the finals or Erdogan. Because I don't think that Lazar will make it to the semifinals. That's my opinion.
Erdogan?
Yeah, his name is also Erdogan, Turkish fighter.
Erdogan, okay.
He's an upcoming strong young fighter.
Okay, well, we'll see.
Yeah.
We'll see, but I think they...
Because the lottery still has to happen, I asked him, at the weigh-in, I think. Oh, yeah. Okay.
Yes.
Your smile gives away everything.
No, but look, it's simple. You know, this is going to be, the lottery is going to be. I don't think it's going to be in the way.
Where do you want to go with Kwasi? Any chance we can see him at one championship?
Well, we offered him. They said we're not interested in him now, but maybe in the future.
I think he fits in there well.
Yeah, I think so as well. But it's a little bit, how do you say?
Yeah.
Some things are a little bit strange.
We're going to see what happens after the tournament.
Yeah, sure, why not?
Good luck on that, Mike.
Thank you.
His brother Chico Kwasi is also coming up. Latest news on him?
Oh, yes, Chico is doing very good for a very long time now. The fight, he's losing like four fights, you know, only one fight. He really lost, or two. He really lost the other ones. They just take from him, that's it.
So he's on a winning streak.
Yes, and now he's
motivated, young.
He's gonna go for the qualifiers for Olympic boxing.
Oh, he's so?
Yes, him together with
Gino Contos.
So we need to fight this February 1st and 2nd in Rotterdam, and let's see what happens.
Is that the Ben Brille
game? No, it's just and Dutch championship.
So you have Gino Contos and Chico Kwasi there?
Yes.
Did I hear that Cedric Manhoef is back at Mike's as well?
Cedric Manhoef, yes, he's training again. And we sorted out our differences.
Glory and K1 keep you busy, but any chance we can see Mike's gym at one championship?
Well, I offered them some fighters, but didn't hear from them. Okay, I hope so. The time will tell. Yes, of course, why not? I want to fight everywhere, also Bellator, you know, but...
I was about to ask, yes, Bellator.
Yeah, it's a little bit strange, you know, I got two good friends over there who was in matchmaking and in high places, but...
I think they fear Mike's gym, that's the point.
No, I don't think so. Maybe I lost my phone number.
I lost your phone number. Mike, a quick update on Anissa.
Anissa? Well, Anissa supposed to fight in Kuen Lung, but, you know, we didn't get that ring, so okay. Now Kuen Lung only does four fights a year.
Yeah.
So that's going to be one problem. On the other hand, maybe she's going to fight on the boxing influencers, just the boxing match.
Okay, cool. Because I want to ask you, wouldn't it be nice if Glory added another ladies division?
Yes, of course, and I think she's going to do very well at Glory, but, you know.
What weight is Anissa? What weight should it be?
Between 60 and 65 kilos.
What would be a good weight division for Glory to add?
62.
62? And that's also because we have big girls in Holland, and they can all fit.
Not only in Holland, you got one good one in Belgium, you got a few good ones in France, you got one or two good ones in Germany, so you can make it official. You got actually two or three in England.
With some bigger girls there?
Yes, well, bigger girls.
Taller, bigger. Mike is buying a flower. Mike, how is the collab with Fosh Gym? Ivan Hippolyte, two gyms under your roof?
Well, actually very well, you know, we help each other out a lot, try to help each other, so that's good.
He has his own dojo here upstairs,
I just got one big room and everybody's training there, and on Wednesday evening we spar together, and that's good for everybody.
Is Ivan here today?
No, he's not. Thursday never.
Mike, any scoops on yours that I missed?
No.
Nah, the smile on your face, nothing.
Wow. What's coming, it's coming. Don't worry about it.